Brazil. Known for its beaches, the Amazon rainforest. Maybe you drink its coffee.
I do. I definitely do.
I think I need some coffee. Or perhaps you've seen and heard its Rio Carnival. It's certainly a country with a rich, diverse cultural background, and much of this is evident in the music Brazil has produced and even exported. Yes, exported. Exported? 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 You can export music, but it's sound. Yes, exported. We'll talk about it later. So let's dive into the incredible array of music this one country has shared with the world as we see what's inside the music box today. Where is that music box? I already lost the music box. First episode, I don't know where the music box is.
Brazil,
can't find the music box. It's a microphone. Over here. It's always good to stay organized. So where were we? The amount of music Brazil has produced alone is astonishing. There are bazillions and bazillions of Brazilian songs out there.
Good one. Clever.
Thank you. You might have heard some of these songs without knowing the point of origin, Brazil. As is the case with so much music out there, unfortunately. Tell me about it. Many of these songs fall into categories based on dances. One of music's most go-to moves, throwing itself onto dances, and then dances throw themselves onto music. They work so well together. So, what are the dances of Brazil? There's the samba, the choro, the baio, and so many more that if you don't know Portuguese, the common language of Brazil, you might fear pronouncing, like me. So I won't. But there they are. Definitely not saying that. Definitely not saying you. No way. But that's what we're here for, to learn. Fortunately, I know someone who knows a thing or two about Brazilian music. He is Brazilian. That helps. So he invited me over to his place in Sunset Park, Brooklyn, for a nice backyard conversation about the music he grew up with. This is João Luiz, one half of the Brazil guitar duo. It doesn't get more Brazilian than that. Also one half of this little guy, who was equally entertaining, but had slightly less to say about Brazilian music. So I stayed the course with João.
On the top of the A, you had the tilde, so it makes it like a more nasal sound, João.
The tilde really stresses us out.
I know. You see the tilde, you panic. If you want to sound really like Brazilian, João.
João.
Wow.
Wow.
Rich, diverse, and rhythmic. It mixes like the Africans who were slaves in Brazil, the Portuguese people who were like the colonizers, and the indigenous people who were already there in the lands.
You already answered the diverse part.
The diverse part also, yeah. Because then you have like this music that it is at the same time very rhythmic, right? So because of the Africans, but it's also, it could be very like melodic and harmonic oriented because of Portuguese and like European influence. With the samba, we would have, again, let's use the 16 note pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So two groups of four 16th notes. Then you can add a variation. One, two, 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 one, two. Right? So let's say we're doing 16ths here, right? Mm-hmm. Then you have on top, so somebody's really can have like so many layers, and it's such like a polyrhythmic. Genre. There's so many layers due to like the use of like multiple like percussion instruments. Yeah. But basically you have the 16th notes. One, two, one, two. And then you have, usually you can have like a lower drum being accented on the second beat instead of one. One, two, one, two, one. What makes it more, I would say, Brazilian is that we put the accents in like different places. Right?
Right.
As opposed to them like even.
As opposed to da 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 da.
Yeah.
Da, da,
da. As opposed to march. Yes, yeah, yeah, exactly. And then we have also baião, which if we like also use as a base is like the 16th notes. It's mm-hmm. Right? And then that would be on the guitar. So shoto is really, I think, is one of the most authentic of all Brazilian types of like music. Some people call it like the Brazilian jazz, and that's our like main instrumental genre.
All right, show us the shoto.
So you can keep like the 16th notes.
All right.
Yeah. So that's very, it's a shoto by a great Brazilian composer and guitarist, very important for the guitar in Brazil. His name was João Pernambuco, also João. Pernambuco is a state in Brazil. João from Pernambuco, right? And he was a great guitarist. He composed a lot of like pieces like this, like shotos, toadas, and other like north, like eastern, like, type of music too. He was a great, great guitarist and composer.
João was even kind enough to play a few songs with me, where he showed me how to dance these dances on the trumpet.
Thank you.
most of us are familiar with the waltz.
It's in three.
And we see often people, we associate the waltz with people in wigs and fancy dresses.
Yes.
And guys wearing really funny outfits dancing in ballrooms to this waltz.
That's true.
A dance that's meant to be
danced. Yes.
You're telling me that there is a Brazilian waltz and it's not meant to be danced.
It's not meant to be danced, yes. But it definitely comes from Europe, from the European tradition of like waltzes and other dances that really shaped what became like the Brazilian instrumental music. Definitely. But this in this case, like most of like the composers, especially in the beginning of the 20th century, and I believe even before, because of the like, it's not a waltz, it's not a type of instrumental music that it comes from like the piano, the orchestra, you know. In Brazil they had like the working class, they had guitars, they had brass instruments. They like by ear they would try to imitate on their instruments. That's when the changes I think occurred. It's a much more like loose like feel to it. And there's also this component that I think it's really important that it really comes also from like Portuguese people, which is this kind of like the longing kind of feeling, like saudade that we use, that nostalgia, you know? That's why you don't have this obligation with the dance steps. It would sound more like a waltz, like that you could dance, let's see. Something like that, like a waltz by like a Spanish composer, Aguado.
Right.
A very typical waltz. But then the Brazilian waltz would be, I'll play one by Villa-Lobos.
I believe the technical term for this is herky-jerky. Would you say that's close?
Well, can you like give me like a thorough explanation of this term?
Well, I guess that maybe even Johann Strauss, who's the waltz king, he alluded to this idea of instead of 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, he would stretch at certain beats. If you hear you know, a classic Viennese waltz,
yes,
the beats aren't all even. And I hear a lot of that in actually both of the waltzes that you play, the sort of herky-jerky, like when you think one is supposed to happen, it doesn't quite happen.
Yes, but I think, well, that's definitely the case. Because like Johann Strauss waltzes were very popular like everywhere, right?
Right.
But I think there's also something to be said about this type of waltz that really it has to do with the way you strum your guitar. Actually, what they're trying to portray is the kind of like the humble like countryman strumming the guitar. And even they mention about the bordões, which is the lower register. Mm-hmm. It's a characteristic of like guitar playing. Yeah. It has to do with this kind of like very, so they not only stretch a lot, but there's no obligation really with the...
You're the master of your own time.
Exactly. But you're right. So you pointed out at the beginning, still written in 3/4.
Right.
It's still called waltz. Pixinguinha. He's the kind of like godfather of like Brazilian music, really. Such an important name for not only choro, but even very important for the development of like the Brazilian music, instrumental music. He played all sorts of like instruments. He played the guitar a little bit. He played the piano. He used to compose quite a lot of piano too. Besides being like a wonderful saxophone player and like flute player. His music is so popular and he was so prolific that everyone plays Pixinguinha. Let me see if I can come up with something from here. Such an important composer who wrote Carinhoso, right? So the lyrics, I'm not a singer.
Meu coração, não sei porquê, bate feliz quando te vê. Ficam sorrindo e pelas ruas vão te seguindo, mas mesmo assim foges de mim.
And he has like also like choros that are really like virtuosic. Thank you.
Many would say the foundation of Brazilian music exists within the samba. Now, the samba has probably become the best-known form of Brazilian music worldwide, especially because of that Rio Carnival I mentioned earlier. Also, the bossa nova deserves mention as a form of music that came out of Brazil. Bossa nova is essentially a mix of Brazilian music with that cool jazz sound. The guy responsible for making that cool jazz sound, one of my heroes, was Miles Davis. And this device here really helped to create that cool jazz sound for Miles. It's a Harmon mute. It's a little beat up. But he took the stem out, and then he put this Harmon mute in the bell of his trumpet. And then he played his trumpet. The person who really popularized the bossa nova early on was Antonio Carlos Jobim.
Deixa cantar de novo trovador, a merengue a luz da lua, toda canção do seu amor.
Now, Antonio Carlos Jobim collaborated with many people, even the great Frank Sinatra.
Your love is rain. My heart, the flower, I need your love, or I will die.
I should also mention the music coming from another duo, Gilberto and Stan Getz. Getz? That doesn't sound very Brazilian.
Olha que coisa mais linda, mais cheia de graça, ela menina que vem e que passa. Doce balanço, caminho do mar. Moça do corpo dourado, do sol de Ipanema, o seu balançado é mais.
Now there's one very popular song that comes from a beach neighborhood in Rio de Janeiro called Ipanema. The girl from Ipanema. These two recorded some music in Los Angeles, home of West Coast jazz, and now importer of bossa nova.
É pau, é pedra, é o fim do caminho, é o resto de toco, é um pouco sozinho, é um caco de vidro, é a vida, é o sol, é a noite, é a morte, é um laço, é um anzol, é peroba do cão,
é o nó da madeira, é o mate da pereira.
Show.
It's important to know the wide variety of music that's out there, but it's also important to know where it came from and how it traveled. So many parts of different types of music have traveled miles and miles through time to get to your ears right now. The journey this music has taken and unknowingly infiltrated your life is truly remarkable, and that's something worth knowing. And through knowing all of this, we can have a greater respect for the places where this music comes from. So thank you for going on this journey inside the music box today.
Oh, yep.
What's up?
Yep, hi, hello.